Hey y'all, welcome to Ms. Clark's chemistry class. In this video, we're going to label our periodic table with all the oxidation numbers. In a previous video, we've labeled our periodic table with the valence electrons. Those are important, but now let's also add the oxidation numbers. Remember, ions have a charge because they've lost or gained electrons, and that charge is the oxidation number. So go grab your periodic table and let's add those to it. It's going to make everything that we do from here on out in the course much, much easier. Okay, so group one has one valence electron. Hopefully you have that labeled on your periodic table. Well, remember the octet rule? Every element wants 8 valence electrons. So elements with one valence electron, the alkali metals, super, super reactive. That's why they're the most reactive group. One valence electron, they want 8. They're the farthest away from 8. But if they lose that one electron, the shell underneath is going to be full. Alkali metals are going to be so much happier. So when elements in group one become an ion, they become a plus one ion. Let's label that on the periodic table. So everything in group one is a plus one. It's going to lose that one valence electron to become a plus one cation. Group two elements have 2 valence electrons. Remember, we're trying to get 8. So they could either lose those 2 or they could gain 6. Nature is always going to go the path of least resistance. It's going to take less energy to lose the 2. So every element in group 2, when it becomes an ion, is going to become a plus 2 cation. Label that on your periodic table.
So everything in group 2 will be a plus 2 cation.
Remember the valence electron trend? We skipped the transition metals, those short groups. We only labeled the tall groups, the main groups. This is the same thing with oxidation numbers. So let's skip over to group 13. 3 valence electrons. So it could lose 3 or gain 5. That's right. Losing 3 is going to take less energy. Let's label that with a plus 3 at the top.
And everything in group 3 will be a plus 3 cation.
Now group 14, we're right here in between with 4 valence electrons. Remember, we're trying to get 8 right there in the middle. Do we lose 4? Do we gain 4? That seems equal energy. I often just label this group plus or minus 4. The elements in this group don't really become ions very often.
So I normally just say plus or minus 4.
Group 15, 5 valence electron. Now, if you think about us traveling up a hill, we started at plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus or minus 4. We added in that minus. Now we're going to start going down that hill. So group 15 has 5 valence electrons. That's right, we're trying to get to 8 still. So we could lose 5 or gain 3. Here's our first group where gaining is going to require less energy. Group 15, let's label that with a negative 3 charge.
So we see everything in 15, 5 valence electrons, the oxidation, negative 3, because we add 3 more to get the 8.
Group 16, 6 valence electrons. We only need 2 more. That's right, it's going to gain 2. Let's label that with a negative 2 charge.
So 16, 6 valence electrons, negative 2 as its oxidation number, gain 2 electrons.
Okay, here we are to the halogens. Halogens, 7 valence electrons. You got it. They're only 1 away. They're so close to reaching the octet rule. That's why they're so reactive. Alkali metals, most reactive metal group, because it's the farthest away from reaching the octet. Halogens, most reactive non-metal group, and it's all about being so close to reaching the octet. So they're going to gain 1 electron. Everything in the halogens, a negative 1 charge.
Group 17, 7 valence electrons, negative 1 oxidation number.
Group 18, they have a full valence shell. They are not going to lose or gain electrons. You could either label it with a 0 or just leave it blank.
Because they are so happy having their 8 valence electrons obeying the octet rule.
These are not going to become ions. Okay, so now our periodic table is all labeled up to make us be successful for the remainder of chemistry. We are always going to need to know how many valence electrons and the oxidation number of possible ions. If this was helpful, go look at the description. There is lots more helpful tutorials there. Also, do you have a friend that's struggling? Just share this video right over to them. Until next time, bye y'all.